Hi, everybody. I'm Amy Abbott, for those of you who do not know me, and I just wanted to bring a word of encouragement to you drawn from Acts chapter 14, beginning in verse 6. And this is a time where Paul and Barnabas were in Lystra, and they were preaching the good news and trying to get the people there to fix their focus and to turn away from the worthless things and the lives that they were living. And while Paul was there, he was preaching and he noticed a crippled man who had never walked before in his life. I love when the Holy Spirit directs us or directs somebody into our lives that we need. And this is what seems to have happened right there. Paul recognized, or excuse me, he noticed this man and he noticed that he had great faith. And he said, "Stand up." And immediately the man jumped up and started walking. He was healed immediately. Glory to God. And there was lots of witnesses there. Lots of people saw this happen. And so they began to decorate and prepare for a sacrifice. They thought that Paul was Zeus and Barnabas was Hermes. And they were going to sacrifice to these Greek gods. And I'm sure this just absolutely disgusted Paul because he wasn't boastful and he didn't want to take recognition for this. He knew it was all God. And he was like, "Wait a minute, stop. We are just human beings like you. And we were just here to share the good news with you and try to remind you of the good things that God has done for you and get you to turn away from these worthless things and this worthless life that you have already, you know, been living in." And that brings me to verse 17, and they're talking about God here. And it says here in verse 17, "But he never left them without evidence of himself and goodness and his goodness. For instance, he sends you rain and crops and gives you food and joyful hearts." Father, I pray right now that this word go forth. I pray, Lord, that you open ears to hear and hearts to receive, including mine, God. I pray, Father, for peace. And I just thank you, Lord, for your word and your evidence. I thank you, God, for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So we're living in a time where there's lots of chaos, and it doesn't even have to be these times. It could have been 6 months ago. It could have been a year ago. We all have trials and tribulations. Temptations always seem to come and go. And these are the things that God uses to strengthen us and to build us up and to build our faith. And they're just things that we have to go through. You know, life wasn't easy for Jesus either. You know, he was persecuted. So why wouldn't we have persecution? Why wouldn't we have struggles? And there's just a lot right now, it seems, that we're all going through worldwide that can take our attention off of God. It can distract us. I mean, we're already distracted anyways with the right here, right now cell phone world, that these things that are occurring can just kind of pull us away. And sometimes it's not even what's going on to the right and left or the things that are going on in our life. Sometimes we just get too busy. Sometimes there's just so much chaos and fear and anxiety in our minds. And sometimes we just kind of take a step back from God. And we need to realize that our focus needs to always remain on Him. It says right here in verse 17 that he never left them without evidence of himself and his goodness. That same evidence is still here today. Listen to the birds singing. Listen to laughter all around you. Watch the children playing outside, or, you know, just the wonderful things that he's blessed you with in your life. The evidence is still here. Look at the mountains and the trees. I know here in East Texas, we can't necessarily look at the mountains, but there's plenty of trees. And it's just so beautiful. I mean, the birds are singing. They're still eating. They're still living. The flowers are still budding up and blossoming. You know, there's evidence all around us. There's an old song that says, "Count your many blessings, count them one by one." Those blessings are still here today, regardless of what's going on around us. It is up to us to fix our focus and get our eyes back on Christ. Get back into the Word of God and prayer. Get back into looking at the good news of Jesus Christ, because God is still the same today. He was the same as he was yesterday, and he'll be the same tomorrow. His mercies, his grace, and his unfailing love and forgiveness is still here for you today.